Okay, so let's consider lidocaine. Now, lidocaine is a class 1 antiarrhythmic, which means it lives in the sodium channel blocker family. We'll cover the different types of antiarrhythmics in another video. It is now, since 2018, the first line antiarrhythmic we could use in ACLS, and its indication for use is for BFib or pulseless VTAC refractory to defibrillation. What that means is you shocked the patient, it didn't work, we're back on the chest, we're doing compressions, we're going to administer an antiarrhythmic, we can use lidocaine or amiodarone, either one is fine. Now, the dosing parameters. 1 to 1.5 milligrams per kilogram. So now you're thinking to yourself, okay, well, when do I administer 1 milligram per kilogram versus 1.5 milligrams per kilogram? Uh-uh, doesn't work that way.
That's not how it works. That's not how any of this works.
We have a range, and I'm gonna reverse engineer that range, starting with how the medication comes packaged. Here's one manufacturer's package, and this is 100 milligrams in 5 mLs. Here's another package. 100 milligrams in 5 mLs. 100 milligrams in 5 mLs. So lidocaine comes packaged 100 milligrams in 5 mLs. So let's think about this. If I wanted to administer 1 milligram per kilogram and I wanted to use that whole ampule, that whole 100 milligrams, my patient would have to weigh 100 kilograms or 220 pounds. If I gave the whole thing, 100 milligrams, at 1 milligram per kilogram, my patient weighs 220 pounds. Now, if I wanted to administer 1.5 milligrams to my patient and use the whole vial, all 100 milligrams, my patient would have to weigh 66 kilograms, or about 146 pounds. So what does that mean? What this means is if your adult patient weighs between 146 pounds and 220 pounds, administer the whole 5 cc's, 100 milligrams, and you will be dosing that patient within the recommended dosing parameters of 1 to 1.5 milligrams per kilogram. Give the whole thing. Now, elderly patients, you may want to cut the dose in half, follow your local protocols. Okay, so initial dosing for lidocaine, first dose, 1 to 1.5 milligrams per kilogram. A second dose, if required, would be half of that, 0.5 to 0.75 milligrams per kilogram. Okay, side effects of lidocaine, what are published are altered mental status, slurred speech, hypotension, and you should watch for hypotension with the administration of any antiarrhythmic, and then seizures pop up a lot, although I've never seen it. However, every time I've administered lidocaine within the context of ACLS, my patient was, at that time, mostly dead, in that they had no pulse and they were not spontaneously breathing. So I've never actually seen a seizure with lidocaine, but it says you want to watch for it. Now, remember, more importantly than any drug we're administering, how are we administering that medication? Remember, antiarrhythmics have to get to the heart to be effective. So after you administer that medication IV, you follow it with a 10 or 20 cc syringe bolus of saline to help push that drug to the heart. If they're in VFib, they have no cardiac output. Compressions provide maybe 20, 25% of their normal cardiac output. We have to help that medication get to the heart quickly and in sufficient concentration to cause an effect. It's lidocaine. I'm Mark, thanks for watching. See you in the next video.